So why does Tallahassee have a love affair with live oaks? I think most people, when they're in the presence of a huge live oak, there's a certain spiritual quality to it that you just can't help but feel. They are magnificent and enormous living things. It's like confronting a blue whale, except you get to do it on land.
Not everyone at this meeting was here for oaks, but about 60 citizens spoke to try and convince the Blueprint Intergovernmental Agency to not tear down this tree as they prepare to reroute FAMU Way.
I'm fighting for something. I ain't fighting by myself. Look at all these white people, black people, foreigner people. Y'all give y'all stuff a hand.
This is not just about saving a tree. This is about social justice.
We didn't vote to make a concrete jungle out of the city of Tallahassee. We did not vote to destroy century-old oak trees.
I just don't understand why they need to cut down all these beautiful oak trees and destroy these neighborhoods.
Tallahassee has a long history of fighting for and trying to preserve its live oaks. Today, we will explore Tallahasseans' love for this iconic southern tree.
If you look at pictures of North Monroe at the turn of the century, it's a canopy road. But as cars came on, they started cutting the trees. And so that was the nexus of the Live Oak Trail, which was started by one woman in town. She was married to a state official. And she organized ladies with the garden club to recognize the live oaks in town and developed a driving trail to visit some of the best ones in town. The May Oak was a famous oak down at the eastern end of the chain of parks, and it had an incredible spread. It became a really important spot for local gatherings, including a May party every year when a lot of the young ladies of the prominent families in town would dress up and they would all gather underneath it. But we still mark the stump of the May Oak in Tallahassee all these years later. And so, at least in the last 100 or so years, it was one lady and her organized lady friends who really called attention to the importance of our big oaks here in Tallahassee.
A modern Tallahassee live oak trail would likely include this tree.
Let's measure this tree, Sam.
Okay.
Here we get a lesson in the longevity of the species.
Yeah. I think we'll average it right here.
Okay. Got it?
Yep.
It's 84.7. So basically, a 6-foot diameter live oak is around 150 years old. And so we said, how old was this one, Sam, again?
175.
Yeah, we figured this one here is 7 feet in diameter, ballpark figure 175. And, you know, the idea that we're going to get a, without counting the rings, and we're not cutting this tree down to count the rings, you're not going to get that specific within a year, a half a year, or something like that.
But it's really difficult to know the ages of live oaks. When they're in a place that they like and people are not abusing them, they can get very big, very fast.
They do grow faster when they're young, like we do. We grow up as juveniles, we hit a plateau, and then we begin maybe to expand, but we don't get any taller. Well, that's what live oaks do. They get up to about 60 feet tall, and then they begin to bulk up. And that's a slow process.
On average, in a community environment, they're 150 to 200 years old is about the lifespan of a live oak. It's still considered a long-lived tree, but I think it's probably shorter lived than people think.
The Benton Oak is one of three large oaks in the path of a soon-to-be rerouted FAMU Way. But is it 500 years old?
Those trees, I would say, are probably just in the range of 100 to 125 years at most. They're not this size at all, so they're much younger. They're not 500 years.
That's still a pretty old tree.
So when this tree started growing, it was probably around the turn of the 20th century. Tallahassee was probably a village of about 3,000 or 4,000 people. This would have been the edge of town. We would have been surrounded by agricultural fields.
The Benton Oak is in the Boynton Still neighborhood, named after an old turpentine distillery. Down the street, we visited two oaks that have since been torn down.
The two trees that we're standing next to here used to be the shade trees for Shingles Chicken House, which was opened in the late 60s by an African-American entrepreneur named Alvin Shingles. And he repurposed one of the old distillery buildings and made it into a restaurant. And he made extremely delicious fried chicken. And people from all over Tallahassee, both white and black, would come to the restaurant. And it was a real anchor for the neighborhood until it closed about 10 years ago. Now that the houses are gone, you know, these trees are the things that really bear witness for the fact that there was a neighborhood here. They're a cultural artifact, even though they're a natural resource.
It takes a permit to chop down most trees in Tallahassee, but only a few trees have absolute protection. These are state champion and exceptional specimen trees.
This tree, as big as it is, does not meet the official definition of a patriarch oak in our tree ordinance here in Tallahassee. It's not considered big enough.
That's kind of a tree that's above and beyond what you would expect as far as health, size, and just general value to the site.
The definition leaves some room for interpretation. What makes a tree historically significant or of greater value than other trees of the species? In the end, Mindy found structural defects in the Benton Oak, clearing the way for it to be demolished. While the city code did not protect the Boynton Still trees, the city is re-examining its future tree preservation goals.
We started the process of developing an urban forest master plan. Our urban forest master plan does help us with recommendations of what we can do moving forward to make sure we're meeting those goals of canopy quality improvement and canopy coverage maintenance. So we're going to be looking at development code to make sure that the requirements for tree preservation and planting are in line with those goals. You know, so it's long term, but this is a long-lived resource and it's a vast resource, so change will take time.
Ultimately, protesters could not save the Benton Oak. But odds are, next time a mature live oak is threatened in Tallahassee, someone will speak up for it.
Back in the 90s, as I recall, the city of Tallahassee used live oaks on a lot of its promotional materials. And indeed, they are emblematic of the city. People can't imagine Tallahassee being Tallahassee without these big live oaks. But we keep cutting them down.
For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas.